Baldwin once said, no one can possibly know what is about to happen. It is happening each time, for the first time, for the only time. Too often at graduations, I think we get so caught up in where we have been and where we are going that we forget to appreciate where we are. Tonight, for many of us, will be the symbolic end of 12 years of friendships, growth, tears, and laughter. It is the final line in our book of adolescence. It is the end of the first of many journeys. Yet, as important as memories are, I feel that it would be ridiculous for me to welcome you here tonight by explaining my history and sharing my experiences. After all, to quote Napoleon Bonaparte, what is history but a fable agreed upon? No speech could truly capture all that we have been through. And to try to incorporate 180 different viewpoints would be impossible. No two people share the same perspective, even if they do share similar points of view. In the end, sometimes it is best to view the past only as a means by which the present is reached. While it has been many different paths which we have chosen and have brought us here tonight, tonight we celebrate the fact that we are here now. And I feel that it is crucial that we appreciate the here and now, rather than constantly looking onward and upward. Albert Einstein warned us not to think about the future, for it will come soon enough. Tomorrow will forever be a mystery that is only solved with the coming of each new day. If we spend our lives wondering what surprises lie ahead, we will miss the miracles of the present. More important than the people we will become is the people that we are. We must live a little in each moment, because success lies not solely in achieving your goals, but also in being able to enjoy the pursuit of them. The reward should be in the journey, not solely in reaching the end. So I suppose that I can only invite all of you to appreciate this night for what it really is. For the last time in our lives, we, the Susquehanna Township class of 1997, are gathered together. We stand before you, unable to fully appreciate the meaning of our experiences so far, and unsure of our future which lies ahead. We do understand, though, that we have come together to celebrate the last few moments we will be a unified class. After tonight, we will leave our friends and our enemies who have made us the people who we are. We will leave the place in the world which we have come to call our own, and will be swept into places with only the knowledge, the character, and the identity which we have been able to gather and develop from our parents, teachers, and most importantly, each other. It is my honor, therefore, to welcome all of you to celebrate the present with us, to share where we are right now, and to appreciate these last final minutes which we will stand together, celebrating these moments without pondering our inconceivable futures or dwelling on our inconceivable past.
Be your bridge of troubled water. We made it. Tonight marks the end. The end of waiting impatiently for the 2:40 bell, of struggling with lockers, of being told to take off hats and get rid of backpacks. Tonight is the end of WIF TV in the morning and end of day announcements in the afternoon, of walking down the same halls every day and seeing the same faces, mostly friendly ones. Tonight marks the end of years of work and anticipation directed toward this graduation. But graduation isn't just an ending, nor is it simply a beginning. We've already begun our journey. It is more of a mile marker. So far, we've traveled the road together, some since birth and some joining in along the way. Now, most of us are splitting up, facing the next section of our journey, which we will travel with new companions. As we move on, we will take with us the lessons we've learned on this early segment of the road. These include more than reading, writing, and arithmetic, more even than arts, sports, music, or college application skills. Each of us has had different experiences to draw on, and each of us has formed our own morals from them. These conclusions will guide our continuing travels. As Aerosmith sings, life's a journey, not a destination. Our real achievement is not solely our diploma, the immediate destination, but the experiences and lessons we gathered along the 13 or so years that we traveled with this end in mind. Many things we're learning are continuous processes. As we face the consequences of our own actions, we learn what's really important to us. I hope we will take the lessons gained by our mistakes and victories in high school and apply these later in defining priorities and making decisions. Along with this evolving set of values, and along with the realization that we have now exited one section of our lives, which we can never re-enter, comes a renewed appreciation of the importance of making the most of every part of the journey while we have the chance. In the words of one of my favorite bumper stickers, "Wherever you go, there you are." Like many of my favorite quotes, this line has several interpretations. Besides emphasizing the need to make the most of the present, it highlights the fact that no matter where a person goes, she cannot escape her personal characteristics. High school has, for us, been an important step in developing these characteristics. We've come across many potential role models through school, work, and family, and have learned from these people about how we do and do not want to act in our everyday lives. The people we have met have taught us the power a smile or kind word has to brighten someone's day, how to get the job done, and perhaps even which job we want to get done. The poet Theodore Rothke once said, "We learn by going where we have to go." Another writer, John Barth, pointed out that this quote could mean two things, depending on comma placement. It could mean, by going where we have to go, we learn. That applies to our lives so far. We've had one prescribed path, and we've learned by following it. It could also mean, by going, we learn where we have to go. This applies to our future. As we choose different roads, our journeys on those roads will teach us which paths we want to choose in the future and how to travel along them. In the real world, as in high school, the most important things we learn will continue to be from the journey itself, particularly from our traveling companions, from the roads we choose to take, and, perhaps most of all, from the roadblocks we encounter. At this mile marker, as we each choose a different fork in the road, I need to thank my traveling companions to this point, the SDHS class of 1997. Galileo said that there is no man so wise that he cannot learn something from every person, and I think I've definitely learned at least one thing each from most of the people I've met in my time in Susquehanna Township, whether it was about science, literature, friendship, or life. I'm going to borrow the slightly rearranged words of Bob Dylan's song, "Forever Young," to convey my best wishes to my fellow graduates as we continue on the road. May your hands always be busy. May your feet always be swift. May you have a strong foundation when the winds change and shift. May your heart always be joyful. May your song always be sung. May you build a ladder to the stars and climb on every rung. May God's blessing keep you always. May your wishes all come true. May you always do for others and let others do for you. Thanks for a good journey.
We have all heard many times that life is not about conquering obstacles, but about the way in which we conquer them. Today it seems that we can conquer anything. We can alter the very blueprint of our bodies in order to cure diseases. We can explore areas of the universe we never even knew existed. And a few weeks ago we saw we can build a machine that can outthink a man in a game of chess. If we are lucky, there will even come a point in our lifetime when we encounter life somewhere else. Our generation has been given tools that boggle the imagination, and we will continue to improve on them. But that is not our most crucial challenge. What is far more important in a world where so many people share so much in common is to retain our individuality. A lot has been said in recent months about the class of 1997, and much of it has been focused on our achievements and our talents. We cannot hide from the fact that we are an accomplished group of people, and we should be proud of that. But sometimes so much focus on the outcome takes away from what is more important. In a class with so much talent, it is easy to forget that the greatest thing we can aspire to be is ourselves. To be ourselves is a lifelong process in which we try to match our inner emotions, thoughts, and beliefs with our outer expressions of them. This class has been lucky in having many people with the courage to be themselves. We have come to know artists, musicians, athletes, scholars, and thinkers, each with a unique way of going about life. And if we're honest with ourselves, these are the people we respect the most. These are the people who have taught us that there is never only one way to think or exist. It is becoming harder and harder, however, to remain an individual. Today, we are all too often labeled intelligent or incapable, rich or poor, liberal or conservative, black or white. And with each category comes a whole list of stereotypes and one more way not to belong. There's not always a lot of room left to be yourself. To be yourself means to measure everything against your own standards. It means that although we have to accept people for who they are, we do not have to accept statements at face value, no matter who is saying them and for how long they've been said. Today, in a society in which so many people will try to tell you that there is only one set of values, having your own philosophy is more important than ever. If you do not have personal ideals, you can be swayed by anyone and anything. That is the task for this class, to as best we can express on the outside what we are on the inside. Martha Graham conveyed this challenge best when she said, "There is a vitality, a life force, an energy, a quickening that is translated through you into action. And because there is only one of you in all time, that expression is unique. And if you block it, it will never exist again through any other medium. The world will not have it. It is not your business to determine how good it is, nor how valuable, nor how it compares to other expressions. It is your business to keep the channel open." It is a challenge that Emerson understood when he said, "Nothing is at last sacred but the integrity of your own mind." There will be many times in our lives that the road will diverge in front of us. There will always be a comfortable option, a path tread many times before by many people. It is okay to take this route, all of us have to at some point. But because each of us is different, there is for every choice a path never worn before. A path a little more uncertain, a little more frightening, but a little more unique. Now, at the first point in our lives when we can begin anew, with the support of our classmates and our families, and with as much optimism as we can muster, it's time to take that road less traveled. So that someday, decades from now, we can say we experienced life for what it is, our journey to be molded by our ideals and nobody else's. A brief opportunity to be someone the world has not known before and will never know again. No matter how uniquely we express ourselves, there are common goals we must maintain. Never shy away from laughter, for the ability to laugh is what makes us human. Never shy away from a life of acceptance, for the world has many people to offer you. Never shy away from kindness, for it's the greatest thing we can offer the world in return. Laughter, acceptance, and kindness will carry us wherever we dare to go. May the roads we walk in getting there be determined by the ideals of which we dream. Thank you.
Good evening. Tonight, we are joined by some very distinguished guests. Let's go back in time 50 years. World War II has only been over for 2 years. A group of young people is graduating from Susquehanna Township High School. Several of those young people from the 1947 graduating class are here tonight. Mr. Lester D. Folk, Mrs. Janet Seltzer McLean, and Mrs. Nancy Brand. I'd like for those people to stand, and if there is anybody else from that class, please stand also. Let's go back a little further. The year is 1932. We're amid the Great Depression. The valedictorian of that class is here tonight, Mr. Lee Moser. Now, we don't know how the next part's going to turn out, but we wanted to try an experiment, so what I'm going to say is, if there's any Susquehanna alumni in the room who are from the class of 1967 or before, please stand. Thank you. These alumni built a foundation for success for future Susquehanna Township classes to follow. The class of 1997 has seized the opportunities provided by the staff and their fellow students. They excel in academics, in athletics, and in music. And tonight, Dr. Holzman will recount some of the achievements of this remarkable class. But I want to take another approach. I want to talk to you about an attribute of this class that's a little different. It starts with the statement that they are a genuinely nice group of people. They like each other. They care for each other's needs. I challenge the class of 1997 to build on that base. Others will stress during the next 4 years learning specific academic disciplines, advancing your career fields, and earning money. But I suggest that there is an additional strategy. True success in America differs from many other countries in a way that makes life truly remarkable. In most foreign countries, social services are provided by the church or by government. In contrast, the United States has a network of 80 million volunteers who go into hospitals to raise money, who go into the inner city to renovate houses, who give glasses to people less fortunate, and who serve as aides in schools. Why do people do this? Well, one reason is because it is needed, but also because it is rewarding. The opportunity to serve other people appears to satisfy some deep human need. As this class proceeds through college, a job, or the military, you may have another way to serve others based upon your experience at SPHS. Your new college roommate may have never met an African American, but you have. Your fellow worker may never have known a Jew, or a Muslim, or a Buddhist, but you have. Your fellow airman may never have known a Hispanic American, or an Asian American, but you have. You have learned in the best classroom possible, the daily interactions in school, how to work together. Oh, it's not perfect, but things in real life seldom are. But you have learned in a practical arena how to mend social relationships. You have much to teach others when you leave Susquehanna. Finally, if others will permit me, a word directly to the class of 1997. During the last 4 years, I have seen you grow and mature as a class. You have individually and jointly set standards that other Susquehanna classes will have to strive to meet. More important personally, you have allowed me to share the process of your development. I am proud of you as a class, and I am proud of you as individuals. Thank you.
Good evening. On behalf of the Susquehanna Township School District Board of Directors, I bring greetings and congratulations to you, the parents, grandparents, relatives, and friends of the members of the class of 1997. To the class of 1997, I bring sincere good wishes for a bright and successful future. You have worked hard and long to achieve this important milestone in your life. Commencement is not an end, but a beginning. You are now embarking on the most challenging and rewarding journey of your lives. Today, your dreams and ambitions lay ahead of you, just out of your reach. Tomorrow, they may be firmly in your grasp. Tonight, we celebrate your recent achievements. Tomorrow, you will reap the benefits. Although you have attended Susquehanna Township High School for 4 short years, you have accomplished much in scholastic achievement, music, and athletics. One only needs to listen to the long list of awards and accomplishments tonight to be truly proud of this fine group of young adults. There is not just one secret to success. Your success was made possible by combined efforts, the dedication of your loving parents, this outstanding faculty, and this administration. They have all helped to prepare you to enter the world and succeed. You yourselves have made that success possible. To conclude, I would like to extend my personal congratulations to all of you, the graduating class of 1997, for making us proud to say we are Susquehanna Township.
Good evening. This is the 14th Susquehanna commencement that I participated in, either as a principal or superintendent. But this is a very different one for me because for the first time, I'm the parent of a graduating senior. And that's tougher than I thought it was going to be. I have a lump in my throat. I'm up here experiencing the same mixed feelings and emotions as the rest of you parents are. Like all of you, I'm very proud of my daughter and what she's accomplished. And I'm also proud of your sons and daughters, the class of 1997. This class as a whole could make a very good case for being a top academic class ever to graduate from Susquehanna Township High School in its 85 years of existence. 91% of the students in the class, the largest percentage in school history, will be going on to higher education, and some will be representing STHS at some of the most prestigious schools in the country, like Harvard, Yale, Penn, Swarthmore, Duke, and many others. 6 members of the class were named National Merit Scholars, the most ever. One of those 6 Merit Scholars was also chosen as a National Presidential Scholar. She was one of only 2 chosen from Pennsylvania, and the only female. 9 students also received commended student status by the National Merit Scholarship Corporation. 1 member of the class received the prestigious John Travers Award, which goes to the top scholar athlete in central Pennsylvania. And that same student was named as one of the 20 Patriot News 1997 Best and Brightest Award recipients. I could go on and on, but all you have to do is look at that list that Mr. Wolfgang was talking about of all those academic scholarships and awards included in your program to be convinced of this class's extraordinary accomplishments. As we all know, this was by no means a one-dimensional class either. Its members excelled in extracurricular activities, just as they did in academics. Led by members of the class of 1997, STHS athletic teams have won a district boys baseball championship, a Mid-Penn girls track title, 2 Mid-Penn boys tennis championships, a Mid-Penn boys soccer title, 2 Mid-Penn 2 boys basketball championships, and of course, a state AAA basketball championship, and that was all in the last 16 months. The marching band, represented by 24 members of this class, also won an unprecedented 2 Section 6 championships, and that's equivalent to a district championship in athletics. And won 2 of those in a row. Last fall, placed 7th in the Atlantic Coast competition, which includes the best bands from 9 states. For the last time, I'd like to join you in congratulating the members of this great class on what they've accomplished, and thank them for the pride that they have brought to all of us, their school and community. I believe that it can be safely said that the people in this class have what it takes to go out and make a positive difference in the world, as Ben was talking about, just like they made a positive difference at STHS. Being a positive force in the world isn't always easy, though. This was made clear to me a long time ago by my mother, who shared with me a very good piece of advice that one of her friends had given to her. I'd like to share it with you guys in the class this evening before officially certifying you for graduation. People are illogical, unreasonable, and self-centered. Love and trust them anyway. If you do good, people will accuse you of having selfish motives. Do good anyway. If you're successful, you will win false friends and true enemies. Succeed anyway. The good you do today will be forgotten tomorrow. Still, do good anyway. The biggest men with the biggest ideas can be shot down by the smallest men with the smallest minds. Think big anyway. People favor underdogs, but follow only top dogs. Fight for the underdogs anyway. What you spend years building may be destroyed overnight. Build anyway. People really need help, but sometimes they attack you when you help them. Help people anyway. Give the world the best you have, and you may get kicked in the teeth. Give the world the best you have anyway. And now, by the authority vested in me as Chief School Officer of Susquehanna Township School District, and by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, I certify that those students receiving diplomas this evening have met all Pennsylvania graduation standards, as well as those required by the Susquehanna Township School District. Congratulations. Now, before commencing with the distribution of diplomas, the graduating members of the class of 1997 would like to applaud their parents and others in the audience for all the love and help that you've given them as they work toward achieving this important graduation milestone. Mr. Wolfgang and Mr. Michelson, you may now present the diplomas.
Plans to attend the University of Pittsburgh and pursue a career in medicine. Adam Stephen Bennett.
Adam has been an inaugural work past around 4 years and served as secretary for his father. Future plans are to attend Harrisburg Area Community College and major in criminal justice.
Lisa Marie Bohenig.
Lisa participated in field hockey as a member of the Key Club. Future plans to attend Kutztown University in the fall.
Edward Grant Boland.
Ed was a member of the National Honor Society, Marching Band, Independent Students of Soccer Team. Peer tutor, worked at Pizza Hut. Ed plans to attend Bloomsburg University, major in business.
Lauren Brooke Bowman, Distinguished Scholar's Diploma.
Lauren was a member of the National Honor Society, Prom Committee, was captain of the Cross Country Team. She works as a cashier at Ben Frank. She plans to attend Philadelphia College of Textiles and Science as a Physician's Assistant major.
Kiana Joy Brewster.
Kiana was a member of the Select Force, Marching Band, Track and Field Team, and Principal's Advisory Committee. She was an active member of Key Club, plans to attend Bennett College, major in Psychology and Nutrition.
Eric Fonzie Brooks.
Eric was Key Club's member, member of the United Nations, Principal's Advisory Committee, and that's Science Towns Organization. Worked for Girls Incorporated, plans to attend the University of Pittsburgh in the fall.
Mark Allen Buckles, Jr.
Mark was co-founder of Science Fiction Club and member of Science Club in the United Nations. He served as a Spanish 1 tutor as a volunteer at Holy Spirit Hospital. Leaves for boot camp on June 16th, Marine Corps, plans to study electronics.
Sean Patrick Burke.
So, 4 year member of the boys' basketball team, 1 year member of the soccer team. Worked as a camp counselor and plans to attend St. Francis College downtown to major in accounting.
Jennifer Nicole Burrow.
Jennifer was a track manager, manager junior year, participated in cadet teaching. She's a tutor for the middle school and her future plans are to be an elementary school teacher.
Anthony Charles Bucilla III, Distinguished Scholar's Diploma.
Anthony was a member of the United Nations, of course, worked as assistant manager of Giant Foods. Future plans are to attend Temple University in the fall.
Susan Buzza.
During high school, Susan worked at Uptown Bateman Hall. Susan's future plans are to attend Harrisburg Area Community College and go to the Pennsylvania State University, Harrisburg.
Amber Marday Marie Carmo, Distinguished Scholar's Diploma.
Amber was a member of the National Honor Society, Youth and Government Marching Band and Jazz Band. She participated in the French Exchange and worked for Bucks County Coffee Company. She plans to attend Bryn Mawr College and major in archaeology.
Amanda Lynn Caracato.
Amanda was an SBA writer, joined her coursework in art photography and served as a student aid. She worked for Pete Curtis and the Wings of Friends. Future plans, travel the country, settle in California, attend college, and eventually own her own business.
Tiffany Deshaun Plee.
Tiffany is a member of the Future Business Leaders of America and that Science Towns Organization. Tiffany serves as Customer Service Representative Hackinger, who plans to attend Westchester University.
James Rush Colston.
James participated in football, wrestling, and track. He serves as the maintenance worker for the school district and plans to enlist in the Army.
Melinda Robin Comer.
Melinda participated in softball and court. Her future plans are to attend Simsburg University and become a physical therapist.
Venetia DeLise Coney.
Venetia was a member of the National Science Challenge Organization. Her future plans are to attend Arts Institute of Philadelphia and receive an associate's degree in fashion marketing, pursuing a career in fashion modeling.
Clinton Leon Prather, Jr.
While in high school, Clinton participated in United Unified Sports, Basketball, and Junior National Association of Cadet. His future plans are to attend Gallaudet University in Washington, D.C.
Michael Robert Spies.
Mike participated in varsity football, unified bowling, and unified softball. Served as girls' basketball manager, library aide, worked in Harrisburg Dairies. Future plans are to attend National Technical Institute for Deaf.
Aaron Gabriel Confer.
Aaron was a member of the National Honor Society, Key Club, and Principal's Advisory Committee. Participated in baseball, basketball, and ice hockey. Worked at Workbook Binding, Isaac Stelly. Future plans are to attend University of Pittsburgh. Peter is a member of the varsity baseball team, varsity cross-country team, and ice hockey team. He is a camp counselor, his future plans are to attend the University of Pittsburgh.
Beverly Michelle Cook.
Beverly was a member of the YMCA, Youth and Government, Geek Club, Flames of Fire. She worked 3 jobs, did a lot of volunteer work. She plans to attend Tacoma Falls College and major in elementary education.
Stephen Joshua Coral.
Stephen works as a salesman at Sears Brown High School. His future plans are attend college and coach.
Daniel Patrick Curran.
Dan participated in football for 4 years, track for 2 years, weightlifting and whip TV. He worked at Paul's Custom Warcraft and plans to attend Kutztown University to major in telecommunications.
Carrie Marie Davis.
While in high school, Carrie participated in softball, color guard, chorus, and band. Future plans are attend college and major in elementary education.
Chow Din.
Chow is a recipient of the Library Service Award and the Faculty Talent Scholarship. Her future plans are attend Pennsylvania State University.
Kelly Lynn Dively.
During high school, Kelly participated in track and was a member of the Key Club. She worked at Isaac's Deli and she will be attending Lycoming College in the fall to become a computer specialist.
Sun Dawn.
Sun arrived in the country in 1995 and attended Susquehanna Township for his senior year. He worked as a volunteer in the Kaiser Prayer Library and Media Center. His future plans are attend Harrisburg Area Community College and study accounting and computers.
Devin Michelle Driver.
Devin was a member of the National Honor Society, Key Club, Concert Band, Marching Band, Orchestra. Served as a volunteer at the Tri-Community Association for Blind and should be attending Grove City College in the fall, majoring in accounting.
Damian Ashley Dyer.
Damian was a member of the Future Business Leaders of America, Key Club, and Chess Club. He will serve as a volunteer at Dolphin Manor. His future plans are attend Harrisburg Community College and pursue a career in accounting.
Benjamin Richard Eckerson.
Benjamin participated in Youth Endowment, Student Endowment, Quiz Bowl, and the school's music group. He was a member of the yearbook staff and worked as a student intern at the Pennsylvania Senate Democratic Information Office. Future plans are attend West Virginia University, major in political science, and later attend law school.
Nicole Amelia Michelle Edwards.
Nicole is a member of the Key Club, Principals Advisory Committee, Students Against Drunk Drive, and Math Science Challenge Organization. Participated in track and field, and she plans to attend Howard University to major in communications.
Orville John Aliyah.
While in high school, Orville worked for Rite Aid Corporation, Giant Hughes, and the Patriot News. His future plans are attend college and obtain a degree.
James William Evans III.
During high school, James participated in the high school's work study program. His future plans are attend West Virginia University and study automotive engineering.
Scott Gregory Farber, Distinguished Scholar's Diploma.
Scott was president of the student government, representative of the school board, and newspaper editor. Participated in the Center for Youth Leadership, Law and Government, Varsity Soccer. Future plans to serve as an intern for Representative Mark McNaught, attend Harvard University, major in international relations with a career focusing on global politics.
Todd Linwin Farrell.
Todd was a 4-year member of course and worked as a clerk for Giant Foods. His future plans are to attend Harrisburg Area Community College and transfer to another college to obtain a degree.
Phoebe Felix.
Phoebe is a member of the Future Business Leaders of America and International Forum. She worked at Manor Care Nursing as a certified nurse's assistant. Her future plans are to attend the Harrisburg Area Community College to become a registered nurse.
Seth Seeger Fisher.
During high school, Seth was a member of the Science Fiction Club. His future plans are to attend Thaddeus Stevens Trade School and study mechanical engineering and technology.
Eric Michael Fishkin.
Eric was captain of the golf team, captain of the tennis team, and a student aide. His future plans are to attend the University of South Florida to major in business administration.
Sarah Flynn.
Sarah participated in cheerleading, diving, cadet teaching, and soccer. Her volunteer work involved being a member of the Big Brother Big Sister program. She plans to attend James Madison University in the fall.
Jasmine Ayana Forney.
Jasmine participated in cheerleading, track, Future Business Leaders of America, and TGIF. She worked at Morrell's Clipping Service and she plans to attend Empire Beauty School.
Emily Friedenberg.
Emily is a member of the National Honor Society, yearbook staff, Key Club, and participated in tennis. She served as Vice President of Communications for United Synagogue Youth. Her future plans are to attend the University of Delaware in the fall.
Jared Roger Freed.
Jared participated in Key Club yearbook. He served as a tutor for middle school students at Progress Elementary. His future plans are to attend West Virginia University in the fall.
Joseph Adam Fry.
Joe participated in Future Business Leaders of America, Principal Advisor, Principal's Advisory Committee, and Key Club. Joe plans to attend Bloomsburg University in the fall.
Constantine Galoyan.
Constantine participated in soccer, track, and the Science Fiction Club. He worked at Red Lobster, and his future plans are attending Drexel University in the fall.
Shannon Matthew Gelbach.
During high school, Shannon participated in football and track. His future plans are attending Lewisburg University in the fall.
Ashley Lane Gilman.
Ashley was a member of the National Honor Society, SLAC, and Girls Ensemble, and she participated in field hockey for 3 years and school musicals for 4 years. She worked for pet therapy as a volunteer at the Jewish Home. Her future plans are to attend Indiana University in Bloomington, Indiana, to major in archaeology.
Michael David Gensel.
While in high school, Mike is a member of the Science Fiction Club and the high school's mass media program. His future plans are enlisted in the Air Force.
Lauren Shira Gold.
Laura was a member of the Students Against Drunk Drivers. She worked at Foot Locker for 2 years and was a nurse's aide for a physically handicapped child. Her future plans are to attend Beaver College and obtain a master's degree in physical therapy.
Seth Brian Goldberg.
Seth participated in WIC TV as a student aide and a 2-year member of the tennis team. He worked as a disc jockey at Twin Ponds and was involved in production and served as a sales assistant at Link 104. His future plans are to attend Pickett College in the fall. Business Leaders of America, Principal's Advisor Committee, and Key Club. His future plans are to attend a 4-year college and major in communications.
Donald Edward Hadley III.
Don participated in marching band, concert band, WIP TV, and ice hockey. His future plans are to attend a 4-year college and pursue a career in TV.
Ronald Wayne Hall Jr.
Ron played football all 4 years of high school. His future plans are to attend a college on an athletic scholarship. Travis Captain of varsity soccer team, holds a school record in a 1-minute run. He's a member of the 96 District 3 baseball championship team. In soccer, Brad is a Midpen All-Star and a Big 11 honorable mention. His future plans are to attend Radford University in the fall and major in physical education.
Kia Lynette
Hanna. High school, he was a member of the Future Business Leaders of America and worked at Robin's Beauty Salon as a receptionist. Her future plans are to attend Harrisburg Area Community College.
Cyria Michelle Harrell.
Cyria participated in the Basketball Charity League Future Business Leaders of America and Math Science Challenge Organization. She served as a volunteer at Community General Hospital for the Red Cross. Future plans are to attend John C. Smith University and major in pre-medicine.
Kelly Elizabeth Abear.
Kelly is a member of the jazz band, concert band, marching band, and county band. She worked at Red Lobster as a hostess. Her future plans are to attend Pennsylvania State University and major in architectural engineering.
Ryan David Hepford.
Ryan participated in tennis and soccer, was a member of the All-State soccer team. He worked at Wise Markets, and his future plans are to attend Stroudsburg University in the fall.
Francis Xavier Hetherington.
While in high school, Frank participated in track and worked as a volunteer firefighter. His future plans are to attend Harrisburg Area Community College and study fire science technology.
Kathy Lee Hill.
Kathy was a 3-year varsity cheerleader, member of the Key Club and student government. She worked at SHS Temps, and her future plans are to attend Indiana University of Pennsylvania and major in psychology.
Gretchen Michelle Hills.
Drexel's a member of the Slack Course, Girls Ensemble, Math Science Challenge Organization, Key Club, and Track and Field. Served as a member of the Church of Sign Language Group, participated in junior missionaries. Her future plans are to attend Delaware State University and pursue a degree in pre-medicine.
Mary Alma Sarah Holmes.
Mary is a member of the Key Club, Planet Marks Club, and participated in Girls Soccer Band Course and Select Course for 3 years. Held leading roles in the school's musicals and worked for the International Order of Rainbow for Girls. Future plans to attend Lebanon Valley College and major in music education.
Jessica Anna Holtzman.
Jessica was class secretary for 4 years and was a member of the National Honor Society, marching and concert bands, chorus, select chorus, girls ensemble, and key club. She'll be attending Duquesne University in the fall to major in communications.
Lauren Alexa Horley.
While in high school, Laura enjoyed her first work in journalism. Her future plans are to earn a degree and pursue a career in child psychology.
Adrienne Marie Halcyon.
While in high school, Adrienne participated in chorus and was a student aide in library, and she served as assistant manager at Claire's Boutique, and her future plans are to manage the Claire's Boutique store.
Jennifer Shayla and Elizabeth Hunter.
Shayla is a member of the Peabody Math Science Challenge organization. She participated in cheering and chorus and completed volunteer work at the East Shore Animal Shelter. Her future plans are to attend the University of Maryland to major in zoology.
Jacob Doyle Huss.
During high school, Jake participated in tennis, golf, and student government. He worked as a student aide for Susquehanna Township Recreation and worked for Susquehanna Township Recreation Department. Future plans are to attend the University of Pittsburgh in the fall.
Alfred Lee Jackson.
Alfred was a member of the Science Challenge Organization and Future Business Leaders of America. He participated in basketball and track, and future plans are to attend Pennsylvania State University in the fall.
Philip Monroe Jackson.
Philip was named an independent all-star football team, received first place to Future Business Leaders of America in Austin State. Participated in band and worked for the Red Cross Youth Group and Patriot News. Plans to attend college and graduate school to be an athletic trainer.
Harold Lee Jacobs.
While in high school, Harold participated in football and softball for a year and worked at Gabriel Brothers. His future plans are to attend Oregon State University or Coffin State University.
Christopher Dean Jones.
While in high school, Chris participated in baseball. His future plans are to attend West Virginia University in the fall. During high school, Lewis participated in cheerleading and worked with Harris Army as a babysitter. Lewis' future plans are to work and be successful in reaching their personal goals.
Svetlana Cantor.
Svetlana worked as a peer tutor and was a member of International Club and the Prom Committee. She participated in cadet teaching, and her future plans are to attend Bloomsburg University in the fall.
Jared Larry Kiter.
During high school, Jared participated in chorus and worked as a bartender. His future plans are to attend Harrisburg Area Community College and then transfer to Penn State University, Harrisburg.
Andrew Leon Kinzinger.
Andy was a member of the Future Business Leaders of America, participated in baseball. He worked at the Ecumenical Retirement Home and Red Lobster. His future plans are to attend Harrisburg Area Community College and pursue a career in engineering.
Jared Harrison Klein.
While in high school, Jared was voted Mid-Penn All-Star and received the 1996 TV Host Player of the Week Award in football. Served as a student aide and worked in landscaping. His future plans are to attend West Virginia University.
Julia Cogan.
Julia was a member of the National Honor Society, Future Business Leaders of America, Key Club, and International Club. She worked as a sales associate at Sears, and her future plans are to attend Towson State University in the fall.
Jennifer Ann Kohler.
During high school, Jennifer attended Pennsylvania Governor's School of the Arts as a member of the Poetic Arts Club and participated in school's musicals. She completed technical theater work, and her future plans are to articulate at Tyler School of Art.
Rachel Ann Kreiner, Distinguished
Scholar Diploma. Rachel is Vice President of the National Honor Society, Vice President of Student Government, and Co-Captain of Softball and Swim Teams. She participated in tennis, and she works as a lifeguard. Her future plans are to attend the University of Pittsburgh and study biological basis of behaviors.
Paul Colgavin.
While in high school, Paul is a member of the soccer team and swim team. Her future plans are to attend Shippensburg University in the fall.
Anthony Edward Lamarck.
Tony was a member of the National Honor Society, Key Club, varsity basketball team, and baseball team. His future plans are to attend Shippensburg University in the fall.
Melissa Ann Lane.
During high school, Melissa worked in Uptown Bingham. Her future plans are to work hard, to attend Harrisburg Area Community College, and become a social worker.
Thomas Mark Lapkowitz.
During high school, Tom was a member of the Key Club, worked as a peer tutor, and participated in chorus. His future plans are to attend the University of Pittsburgh in the fall.
Kelly Ann Lashinsky.
Kelly participated in swimming for 3 years for high school's musicals. Member of chorus, county chorus, select chorus, girls ensemble, and she worked part-time all through school. Future plans to attend Harrisburg Area Community College, obtain an associate's degree, transfer to Penn State University.
Megan Lynn Lounslager.
Megan participated in marching band, concert band, ski club, girls soccer, and high school's musicals. Her future plans are to attend California University of Pennsylvania in the fall.
Candace Jo Lee.
Candace participated in chorus and worked as a cashier and produce worker for 2.5 years at Giant Food Services. Her future plans are to attend Harrisburg Area Community College to pursue a career in nursing or social work.
Sarah Ellen Lewis.
Sarah was an assistant editor of SQ, and she enjoyed her coursework in journalism and photography. She worked with Mr. Deli, and her future plans are to attend Indiana University of Pennsylvania.
Mark Elliott Lopez.
During high school, Mark was director of student talent show and participated in band, chorus, and Hannah dance. Mark's future plans are pursue a career in the medical field.
Jeremy David Lynch.
Jeremy was a member of Key Club, the golf team, that was a peer too. He worked with Mark's players, and his future plans are to attend the University of Pittsburgh in the fall.
Braden Jerron McLean.
Braden was a member of the Math Science Challenge organization. He plans to attend Harrisburg Area Community College and transfer to the University of Pittsburgh to major in computer science.
Richard Donald McPhee, Jr.
While in high school, Richard worked as a salesman at Sears. Richard's future plans are to attend college and study to become a history teacher. So is a member of the National Honor Society, Keith Club, Student Governor, and Boys Basketball Team. He worked with J.C. Penney, and his future plans are to attend college and graduate school to pursue a career in the health medical field.
Anna K. Messick.
And participated in chorus, county chorus, selected girls ensemble, high school's musicals for 3 years, cadet teaching, and a swim team for 2 years. She worked part-time all through high school. She plans to attend Harrisburg Area Community College, transfer to Bloomsburg University, pursue a degree in elementary education, speech pathology.
Adam Robert Miller.
And participated in soccer and high school's WIP TV programs. Future plans include attending college.
Jason Christopher Miller.
While in high school, Jason was working toward his black belt degree in karate. His future plans are to achieve the black belt in karate, continue to work at Harrisburg Paper Company, and attend Harrisburg Area Community College and major in computers.
Jeffrey Darren Miller.
Jeff was a member of the National Honor Society baseball team. He worked at the Patriot News and Sports Department. His future plans are to attend Messiah College to study accounting.
Deirdre
Lasha
Milliner.
Deirdre was recipient of the Blair Beauty School Scholarship. Her future plans are to become a beautician.
Lee Olminick.
He participated in band, chorus, high school's musicals, and was a member of the hockey team. He worked as a lifeguard at the local pool, and he plans to attend West Virginia University to major in music, theater, and dance.
Thomas Bruce Montgomery.
Bruce is a member of the concert band, marching band, jazz band, and is a basketball team statistician. His future plans are to attend Bloomsburg University to study chemistry.
Christopher Sean Morris.
Chris was a member of Smithsonian staff, Yearbook staff, Key Club. Future plans are to attend Kutztown University, major in communications and administration.
Ennis Jordan Curtis.
Ennis lettered football as sophomore, junior, and senior years. Served as a volunteer at the Bethesda Mission and plans to attend University of Pittsburgh in the spring of 98.
Lisa Lynn Murphy.
Lisa was a member of the Credit Cards Club and worked at the RX Place in Cosmetics. Her future plans are to attend the Pennsylvania School of Art and Design and transfer to the School of Visual Arts.
David Joseph Nanovic.
David was a member of the varsity baseball and soccer team. He participated in the Unified Bowl and worked at Uptown Bingham. His future plans are to attend West Virginia University in the fall.
Kevin Marcus Nicholson.
Kevin was a member of the boys' basketball team and Math Science Challenge organization. He worked at Sears Roebuck & Company. His future plans are to attend Drexel University to major in information science and technology.
Kelly Lynn Nordholm.
Kelly was a member of the marching band, concert band, chorus, swim team, and track team. Her future plans are to attend Lock Haven University in the fall.
Pamela Suzanne
Nerton. Pam participated in soccer, diving, and school's musical. She was a member of the Key Club, and her future plans are to attend Clemson University to major in marine biology.
Gladys Mary Alford.
Gladys is a member of the Future Business Leaders of America, served as a track manager in 9th and 10th grade years. She was president of her youth group at church, completed volunteer work at the American Red Cross. Future plans are to attend Johnson C. Smith University.
Maggie Lowry Ostall.
Maggie was a member of the National Honor Society, Key Club, Marching Band, Concert Band, Jazz Band, Swim Team, and Chorus. She works as a lifeguard. She will be attending Duke University in the fall to pursue a career in marine sciences.
Brandy Shalee Palmore.
Brandy participated in track and field hockey course as a member of Mass Science Challenge organization. Future plans are to attend a four-year university in the fall.
Jason LaVon Pate.
High school, Jason participated in football and worked at Boston Park. His future plans are to attend college and come to Florida. Denise Durham, during her high school years, enjoyed playing basketball, running, and swimming. Her future plans are to attend Harrisburg Area Community College for 2 years.
John Robert Patterson.
John was a member of the National Honor Society, Mass Media Club, Principal's Advisory Committee, and participated in WIP. Worked as systems manager for Mental and Logistics, did independent computer subcontracting. Plans to attend Worcester Polytechnic Institute and major in computer science.
Michelle Elizabeth Pierce.
Michelle is a varsity cheerleader, 9th, 10th, 11th grade years, participated in Hannah Dance Chorus. She worked at Chuck E. Cheese and for 1 year as a student demonstrator at Ritchie School of Dance. Her future plans are to attend Harrisburg Area Community College to pursue a career in nursing.
David Michael Pender.
While in high school, David was a member of marching band, concert band, and chorus. His future plans are to attend Seton Hall University, major in computer science.
Robert Edward Pierce III.
Robert was a member of the Marching Band, Concert Band, Track and Field Team of the Mass Science Challenge Organization. He plans to attend Westchester University in the fall.
Anne Maurice Pittman III.
Maurice was a member of Future Business Leaders of America, Mass Science Challenge Organization, and the Boys Varsity Basketball Team. He worked as a youth basketball camp counselor. His future plans are to attend college.
Christopher Joseph Palm.
During high school, Chris participated in golf, baseball, and music development. He worked at Santos, and his future plans are to attend Harrisburg Area Community College in the fall.
Matthew Fry Papowski, Distinguished Scholar's Diploma.
Matt was a member of the National Honor Society Student Government, the baseball team. He was co-captain of the soccer team, newspaper editor, and intern at Dalton County Historical Society. His future plans are to attend Haverford College in the fall.
Shayna Elizabeth Pounds.
Shayna participated in field hockey and soccer and worked at CBS Pharmacy. Her future plans are to attend Indiana University of Pennsylvania in the fall. Joe is a member of the National Honor Society and the Science Challenge Organization of Principals Advisory Committee. He worked at Wise Bar and Friendlies. His future plans are to attend college, to major in biology, and become a surgeon.
William Henry Pratt, Jr.
William transferred from East Pennsburg, where he participated in stage crew and chess club. He was a volunteer as a big buddy for the Special Olympics. His future plans are to become involved in the field of electronics and computer services.
Aaron Bridget Tuzinski.
Aaron worked part-time at Hamlet Music and volunteered at Rainbow in the City Day Camp program. Her future plans are to attend college and achieve a master's degree in social work.
Adam Gardner Reedy.
Adam was a member of the National Honor Society and participated in football, baseball, and chorus. His future plans are to attend Dickinson College in the fall.
Bradley Wayne Reist.
Brad was a member of the Mass Media Club, Principal's Advisory Committee, and participated in WIP TV. He was a volunteer firefighter and worked as a manager in Allen's Market. He plans to attend Harrisburg Area Community College in the fall.
Terry Jamar Robinson.
Terry worked at McDonald's, in telemarketing, and with for a warehouse company. He plans to continue employment at a warehouse company, attend Bloomsburg University with a scholarship to study nursing.
Juan Ramon Rodriguez, Jr.
Juan was recipient of the Rusty Rod Kaiser Award of Special Achievements. He participated in football and sophomore year and obtained audiovisual work experience. He plans to continue in that field after graduation.
Miguel Angel Rodriguez.
Miguel was also a recipient of the Rusty Kaiser Award of Special Achievements. He participated in football his sophomore year and worked at UPS. He worked in the audiovisual field and plans to continue in that field after graduation.
Matthew Philip Rosenberg, Distinguished Scholar's Diploma.
Matt was a member of the National Honor Society, Yearbook Stamp, and Union Government. He participated in ice hockey and his future plans are to attend Pennsylvania State University in the fall.
Paul Lucas Sanborn.
During high school, Paul participated in football, was a volunteer firefighter, and worked in maintenance. His future plans are to continue in the field of firefighting.
Fiona Marie Scales.
Fiona was a member of the Future Business Leaders of America and distributed of Education Quality of America. She worked at Hershey Park and for Telecommunications Education Fund. Her future plans are to attend college and manage a business.
Julie Lynn Schreiber.
Julie was a member of the National Honor Society, participated in district chorus, county chorus, and schools musicals for 4 years. She performs local venues throughout the area. She plans to attend Berklee College of Music to pursue a career as a professional musician.
April May Scott.
April was a member of the Future Business Leaders of America, the Mass Science Challenge Organization, Marching Band, Track and Field. She worked as a representative for the American Cancer Society, and her future plans are to get involved in the United States Army to attend college.
Thea
was a member of the National Honor Society, Future Business Leaders of America, and Mass Science Challenge Organization. She participated in charity and worked at Chuck E. Cheese. Her future plans are to attend Steele and College and major in psychology and pre-law.
John Andrew
Sion. While in high school, John participated in football as sophomore, junior years, and wrestling as junior. He learned how to be in uptown video. His future plans are to be successful. Blanca was a member of the National Honor Society, Youth and Government, Model United Nations, 96 Girls Championship Track Team. Volunteer with Guilford Police in England for 2 years. She plans to attend Drexel University as an AJ Drexel Scholar and pursue a career in engineering.
Michael Sheen.
Mike was a member of the National Honor Society, participated in soccer and tennis. He was a student aide and worked as a peer tutor. Plans to attend the Pennsylvania State University in Nepal.
Derek Adam Shuttlesworth.
Derek was a member of the Science Fiction Club, Bowling Club, and Chess Club. He participated in mass media and plans to attend Harrisburg Area Community College for 2 years and complete an internship at Fox 43.
Michael Harris Sinaway, Distinguished Scholar's Diploma.
Mike was president of the National Honor Society and participated in golf, youth and government, and quiz bowl. His future plans are to attend the University of Pennsylvania and major in economics.
Juwan Allen Stanley.
Juwan worked at Giant Foods. His future plans are to attend Harrisburg Area Community College for 2 years and then transfer to Morehouse College.
Jacqueline Renee States.
Jacqueline participated in cheerleading as part of the French Exchange Program. She was a former pastry restaurant worker, and her future plans are to take a year off and save money to attend college.
Tanya Mari Stasnik.
Tanya was a cadet teacher, peer tutor, and a member of the Key Club. She tutored middle school students and was host and producer of a kids' radio network. Her future plans are to attend college and pursue a career in broadcast communications.
Holly Ann Stekovich.
During high school, Holly participated in chorus. Her future plans are to attend Harrisburg Area Community College in the fall.
Marion Jean Stewart III.
Marion participated in chorus and track. His future plans are to attend the University of Pittsburgh in the spring of 1998.
Richard Dean Scott.
During high school, Richard participated in football and worked at the Glass Lounge. His future plans are to attend Harrisburg Area Community College and study electronics.
Amy Louise Sturtz, Distinguished Scholar's Diploma.
Amy was a member of the National Honor Society, the Yearbook, Key Club, Color Guard. She participated in school musicals, and was a volunteer cook at the Tri-County Association for the Blind. She plans to attend Oberlin College in the fall to major in psychology or sociology.
Shannon Denise Swinmore.
Shannon was a member of the Future Business Leaders of America, Color Guard. She worked as a cashier at Giant Foods, and her future plans are to attend college and attain a degree in nursing.
Amanda Dawn Thompson.
Amanda participated in basketball, softball, and tennis. Her future plans are to work over the summer and attend the University of Pittsburgh Johnstown in the fall to major in physical therapy.
Karen Ann Thompson.
Karen was a member of the marching band, jazz band, concert band, brass ensemble. Her future plans are to attend Westchester University and major in criminal justice.
Raymond Thorn.
Out of high school, Ray completed work, volunteer work for Meals on Wheels. His future plans are to attend Westchester University.
Kathleen Aaron Thorn.
Kathy participated in field hockey, chorus, and key club. She was the official mascot of the state championship basketball team. She worked at Mr. Daly Institute. Her future plans are to attend the University of Pittsburgh to study civil engineering.
Katie Orestes-Tillman.
Katie participated in football, wrestling, and track. He worked as a banker for Giant Foods. His future plans are to enlist in the United States Army for 3 years and attend college. son participated in wrestling, track, and cross country. He worked construction, and his future plans are to attend a technical school.
Corey Alexander Turk.
Corey is treasurer of the student government, member of the National Honor Society, Key Club, Field Hockey Team, and Girls Soccer Team. Sports editor of the yearbook, and future plans are to attend Pennsylvania State University and major in biology.
Stacy Lee Vogelsong.
Stacy participated in high school's work study program. She worked at Pittsburgh crankshaft for 2 years, and her future plans are to attain a job and then go to college.
Stephanie Nicole Wallizer.
Stephanie was a member of the National Honor Society, of course. Her future plans are to attend Shippensburg University in the fall.
Jada Maisha Washington.
Jada is a member of the Future Business Leaders of America, Vocational Industrial Club of America. She works as cashier, babysitter, and customer service representative. Her future plans are to attend Harrisburg Area Community College and major in business management.
Christopher James Weber.
Chris participated in soccer and Key Club in his 10th and 11th grade years. He was on the web page design crew and worked at CVS Pharmacy. Plans to attend Drexel University to study computer electrical engineering.
Abby Lynn Weisberger.
Abby is a member of the National Honor Society Student Government, Key Club, Diamond Team, and Tennis Team. Yearbook editor, camp counselor in Romania, and worked for Family Support Services. Future plans are to attend at James Madison University and major in sociology.
David Jill
Weiner. David participated in the Modern United Nations, the school's musical and field hockey course. Her future plans are to attend the University of Pittsburgh in the fall.
Eric William Whitland.
Eric started his own national sports cars business. His future plans are to spend his freshman year in college at Hebrew University in Israel. He plans on majoring in business.
Amanda Lynn Yannick, Distinguished Scholar's Diploma.
Amanda was a member of the National Honor Society. Participated in marching band, chorus, track, and the school's music. She plans on attending Shippensburg University to major in criminal justice.
Kristen Ann Martin Zeck, Distinguished Scholar's Diploma.
Kristen was president of YMCA Youth and Government, member of chorus, marching, concert, and jazz bands, wind ensemble, and the International Club. She's an English as a second language. She was English as a second language tutor, volunteer for Trester Lutheran. Future plans are to attend College of William and Mary to major in history and minor in anthropology.
Jennifer Marie Zorick.
Jen was a member of the National Honor Society, Key Club, varsity basketball team for 4 years, and varsity field hockey team for 4 years. She works as a sales representative for Harrisburg Senators. Future plans are to attend University of Delaware to study physical therapy.
Jessica Ashley Allen, Distinguished Scholar's Diploma.
I present the class president, Jessica Allen. Jessica was a member of the National Honor Society, Youth and Government, who was editor-in-chief of the yearbook and captain of the swim team. She's a progressive swim lesson instructor and a lifeguard. She plans to attend Western University and major in biology with a focus in genetics.
Jessica Sarah Muscovitz-Champagne,
Distinguished Scholar's Diploma. Jessica is our class salutatorian. She's president of the Building Arts Club, president of the Science Club, participated in tennis and the Quiz Bowl. She's an actuarial intern at the Food Bank and Habitat for Humanity. Her future plans are to explore the world at Yale University.
Benjamin David Gillen.
Tennis is our highest valedictorian. He's a member of the National Honor Society, varsity tennis team, and varsity cross country team. During high school, he worked with Tri-County Association for Blind. His future plans are to attend Swarthmore College in the fall. One correction, my apologies, Rachel Kreiner is going to be attending the University of Pittsburgh. I'm sorry, University of Pennsylvania.